What's up, mga katoto? I have decided to make a series of videos about the use or the practical use of Pearson Square method in formulating farm rations. In the first video, we will cover the basics of Pearson Square method in formulating diets with two ingredients and one nutrient. In the second video, we will show you how to use Pearson Square if there are three or more ingredients to be used. The third video will discuss how to calculate a diet if you will use a fixed percentage of one or more feed component. And finally, in the fourth video, we will formulate a representative ration for ruminants such as cattle, goats, and sheep. But before we continue, make sure to click the subscribe button and notification bell to make sure you will not miss the succeeding episodes. I mentioned in my previous video entitled Least Cost Feed Formulation Using Excel that Pearson Square method is ideal if you will be calculating simple rations involving one nutrient and two ingredients. Another feature of this method is that the desired nutrient level should be intermediate between the nutrients of the ingredients you will be using. For example, suppose you are to formulate a diet with 17% crude protein or CP, you might use corn which has an approximate CP of 7.5% and soybean oil meal with 44% protein content. 17% CP being an intermediate of the CP content of corn and soybean meal. So moving on, using our example, the first step is to draw a square. Then write the desired CP in the middle of the square and put corn along with its CP content in the upper left corner of the square and soybean meal on the lower left portion. Subtract the CP content of corn from the desired protein level and place the difference diagonally opposite that of corn. So 17 minus 7.5, you'll get 9.5. And do the same with the soybean oil meal. 44 minus 17, you will get 27 parts. Okay? So right now, we have the number of parts of each ingredient needed to satisfy the requirement. But we need to express these figures in terms of percentage for practical considerations. So the next step is to get the sum. So 27 plus 9.5, you'll get 36.5. Then divide 27 parts of corn by 36.5 and multiply it with 100 and you will get 73.97% of corn. Do the same for soya. So 9.5 divided by 36.5 multiply by 100, you will get 26.03% soybean meal. Sum it up, you will get 100%. So in our example, you will need 73.97% of corn and 26.03% of soybean meal to get the desired protein content or CP of 17%. Okay, so let's check if our calculation is correct. So to check, simply multiply 73.97% by the CP content of corn, which is 7.5%, and you will get 5.55% CP. Do the same for soybean meal. So 26.03 times 44%, you will get 11.45% CP. Get the sum and you will see that you have the correct percentage of CP, which is 17%. Alright, so that's it, mga katoto. Please watch out for the next episode of this series. And if you like this video, please don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and write your comments below. Bye-bye!